In June 2019, Jeff Nelson and Reg Source released a fascinating, well-researched video discussing the potential harmful effects of taking DHA supplements, including algae-derived DHA. Jeff has thoroughly researched the subject, with this video in particular being over an hour long, packed full of scientific research, and I highly recommend you watch his series and research the topic for yourself. One of the concerns raised in the video is the connection between omega-3 fatty acids and prostate cancer, which was extremely worrying. One of the studies featured in the video came to this conclusion, quote, "This study confirms previous reports of increased prostate cancer risk among men with high blood concentrations of long-chain omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids. The consistency of these findings suggests that these fatty acids are involved in prostate tumorigenesis. Recommendations to increase long-chain omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acid intake should consider its potential risks." I have to be honest, I'm still researching this subject for myself, and I really encourage you to do the same. Dr. Joel Fuhrman and Dr. Michael Greger both recommend we take a vegan DHA supplement, so I think it's important we hear their take on these findings. The first clip comes from Red Pill Vegan's interview with Dr. Greger. I highly recommend you watch his video in full. The link is in the description. The second comes from Dr. Fuhrman's video, titled "The Need for DHA by Vegans," linked below.
It appears there may be some risk for men with prostate cancer in some recent research with taking supplemental DHA. And so Dr. Michael Clapper recently published a video about that and said he's going to stop recommending it. I was just curious, have you seen that research yet, or is it something
Hand
that's
it
on
over.
Your radar?
Hand it over.
Okay.
Looking forward to it. I'm open, so always.
Currently, you're still saying it's optional but not necessary for DHA?
I recommend people consider it. I take it myself. Recommend people consider it. But if people are randomized to DHA and the prostate cancer gets worse, I would stop recommending it.
So it looks like from the research that I've seen, it's only a small subset of men. What happens, I think, the long-chain omega-3 fatty acids saturate the prostate in a supplemental form.
But presumably they're taking fish oil. I mean, that's how most people take DHA. They don't take some algae oil.
Okay.
So you're saying people take fish oil has more prostate cancer? That's not a shocker.
Not a surprise,
I mean, particularly because you can just get some of the lighter pollutants to distill off. But even steam distilled fish oil can be packed with pollutants. So, I mean, that wouldn't surprise me at all. I gotta see the study.
If the research is specifically on algae-based DHA, would that be, if there was an increased risk of prostate cancer, would it be enough for you to change your recommendation?
Well, it depends. So it was an observational study?
I don't know. I haven't seen it myself.
So presumably it was.
Yeah.
And so then you'd worry about two things, confounding factors and then reverse causation.
Yep.
Just can't prove cause and effect, but let's check it out.
Let's go on to the idea that taking a low-dose DHA supplement can cause prostate cancer, and that's why we must avoid this, according to Nelson. This study appears to be how he first convinced Dr. Clapper to stop taking or recommending DHA. First of all, the study in question did not look at DHA intake, fish intake, or algae DHA supplement intake. They only looked at plasma phospholipid levels of omega-3, not the standard acceptable research test. An omega-3 index, because it's a measure taken from red blood cells, is a more accurate and reflective of longer-term DHA status. Nevertheless, the two blood samples used were not drawn decades before and do not reflect years of omega-3 levels or intake, just likely how much fish they were eating in the days or weeks before the blood was drawn. Keep in your mind that the major finding in this study was that low levels of trans fat were associated with more cancer, and the lowest levels were found with more aggressive cancer. Trans fat, as you might have heard, is outlawed. It's the most dangerous fat a person can eat. Yet this study showed higher amounts in the blood was protective against aggressive prostate cancer. If the result of this study are to be taken seriously, we should be eating margarine and Crisco oil to protect ourselves from prostate cancer. Remember, cancer causes accumulate for decades before diagnosis. The researchers only had two blood draws, and the first one was drawn before the men knew they had cancer. The second one, drawn a few years later, may have included men who found out they had cancer or had at least noted a rising PSA, so they could have modified their diet as a result. All we know from this study is that men with more advanced or aggressive prostate cancer were eating more fish. Men noting a rising precancerous PSA or prostate cancer typically try to eat healthier with less meat and more fish. So we don't really know the significance of this trivial finding that found a very slightly higher plasma omega-3 level in this group with more aggressive cancer. It may be from higher fish intake causing a problem, or it may just reflect the timing of the second blood draw. Nevertheless, it has nothing to do with vegans using a small dose of DHA to prevent deficiency. These results can only make sense if some were informed that they were at heightened risk and then started to eat better with less trans fat and less junk food and started to eat more fish instead of red meat. The fact that trans fats were so low in those with aggressive cancer indicate that some men who developed these cancers likely were aware they had some problem brewing. There is no way higher levels of dangerous man-made trans fats could be protecting against prostate cancer, so we know these findings must be a red herring. If we think the findings from this study indicates DHA causes cancer, then we should be eating margarine and more potato chips and fried fast foods to protect against prostate cancer. Obviously, this finding and this study are meaningless. Prostate cancer is a slowly growing disease taking decades to manifest and to advance to those advanced ages. If this study reflected the actual effect of omega-3 fatty acids, we would see more prostate cancer in Japan, where they eat so much fish throughout life, taking in 8 times the amount of fish oils compared to the Americans. And their DHA levels are double the levels compared to the US, but they have less than a third of the prostate cancer we see here. If we are considering something so surprising and unlikely that even a low dose of DHA would cause prostate cancer, at least the person presenting that position should review all the studies looking at this question and see where the totality of the evidence points. A fundamental aspect of quality research is consistency and repeatability. Reputable studies looking at this question show the opposite. They show a higher DHA levels are associated with lower risk of prostate cancer. A recent meta-analysis of fish and prostate cancer showed fish had a protective effect on prostate cancer mortality. And there are many studies, and the results have not been consistent. There are some theories about the possible reasons for the increases in risk seen in a few of the studies. It could be the accumulated heavy metals or other pollutants in fish, and very high doses of EPA and DHA from fish oil can have an immunosuppressive effect. There's also the possibility of detection bias, where health-conscious men are more likely to eat fish or take fish oil and have PSA screenings, making a diagnosis of prostate cancer more likely. My advice for those eating plant-rich diets has always been to avoid high-dose fish oil supplements and instead take a small dose of a vegan EPA DHA instead. The fact that there may be some small potential risk from a high dose of fish oil or from eating lots of fish has no bearing on the recommendations for non-fish eaters to take a small insurance dose of algae-derived EPA and DHA to prevent insufficiency and protect brain health with aging. Dr. Ornish showed his nutritional program reversed prostate cancer, and his program included 3 grams of fish oil supplements a day. The idea that a well-designed vegan diet with just a low dose of an algae supplement, 250 milligrams, to avoid a deficiency in DHA would cause prostate cancer is not only unsupported, but ludicrous. And mentioning Dr. Ornish, his recent review of much of the science had him change his prior advice, and now he recommends not only DHA, but also that his heart patients and others consume some nuts and seeds in their diet. Of course, all of you are free to have your own conclusions and beliefs without being attacked.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.